When we execute the load slideshows task from the onCreate method, which we looked at in the previous video, of course its doInBackground method gets called to perform that task in a separate thread of execution. Now, at line 84, you can see here that we first check to see if the slideshow file exists or not. If the slideshow file does not exist, then we don't need to attempt to load slideshows from that file yet. Instead, we would go all the way down here, and at lines 114 and 115, we can check that slideshow list is equal to null, and if so, go ahead and create the new array list of slideshow info objects. However, if this particular file does exist, that means that we've previously saved some slideshows out to the device, and in that case, what we want to do is try to load up those slideshow info objects. And we store them, as you'll see in the next video, in the save slideshows task. We store those slideshow info objects as one list of slideshow info objects, and when you output a list of items, again, the serialization mechanism is going to build an object graph of all the things that the list refers to, which consists in this case of a bunch of slideshow info objects, and then separately what each of the individual slideshow info objects refers to as well. So as you'll see in the next video, with one statement, I'm able to output the entire list of slideshow info objects, and as you're now seeing here with one statement, we're also going to be able to read that list back in. Now, in order to input a serialized stream of bytes, we need an object input stream, and we're creating a new object input stream here, and because an object input stream does not know how to read from a stream, all it knows is what to do with the bytes once they've been read, we have to pass to the object input stream constructor some sort of input stream, which I like to refer to as a physical input stream, one that really knows how to read bytes from somewhere. In our case, we're using a new file input stream because these bytes are stored on the device in a file, but it just as well could be a network-based input stream that's reading these bytes from a server somewhere on the internet. Now, once we've created the object input stream, this is going to open the file automatically if, in fact, it's capable of opening the file, that is, no error occurs. And once we do that, you can see here we simply say input.readObject, which says get me the next object from the file. Now, the file contains one object, the list of slideshow info objects, and we know that's the only thing that we put into the file, so we are casting that result, which comes back as type object, to type list of slideshow info objects, and we're storing that in our slideshow list. Now, if I hover over this, you'll see that we're getting a warning here about type safety. We have not checked to make sure that the object that was returned is indeed a list of slideshow info objects. We do know that because that's the only thing we'll ever write into the file, so we didn't check that cast, but what we really should do is store the return value of read object into some variable of type object, then use an if statement to see if that variable is an instance of type list of slideshow info. If it is, then we could apply the cast and store the result, and that would eliminate this warning. Now, you can also see, if we hover over the warning again, that another possibility would be to add at suppress warnings to this function, and that would prevent this warning from showing up inside of Eclipse. Now, if our try block fails for any reason, we do want to notify the user that there was a problem. So in our catch block here, we're calling run on UI thread, which is an inherited method that we get from activity that says I want to do something back in the user interface thread of execution. Remember, right now we're looking at the doInBackground method of the load slideshows task, which is actually executing in a physically separate thread of execution. And the new runnable task that we're saying to execute back in the GUI thread is simply going to display a toast message indicating that there was a problem loading the slideshow info information from the device. Back down to the bottom here, once again, just reiterating, at lines 114 and 115, after the try-catch executes, if the slideshow list is still equal to null, that means we did not read anything from disk, in which case we will create the array list of slideshow info objects. And then finally, we have our onPostExecute method, which, remember, gets called back in the GUI thread of execution. And for this, we're going to create the slideshow adapter object, and we're going to set it as the adapter for the slideshow's list view.